What's going on, everybody? Slugfest Wizard back at it again to give you guys my MMA update. And as well as my predictions for the card that everyone's talking about this Saturday night. First of all, Dana White and Fox got it done. The UFC is finally going to be on the Fox Network sometime in November. I think November 12th or the 26th. And Chris Lytle has retired from mixed martial arts, finally. Well, I guess not finally, but, you know. The UFC itself is also finally back in Brazil after being gone for more than a decade, and Yushin Okami finally gets his title shot. Alright, first I'm going to give you guys my brief thoughts on UFC 133, Rashad Evans versus not Phil Davis, Tito Ortiz. Overall, this card kind of reminded me of Cruz versus Faber, in which the preliminary card left a lot to be desired. It was kind of slow, nothing to write home about. And then when I got to the televised card and the main card, it was pretty damn good. And that's how it went with here with this one too. Rory McDonald got the win. That guy is looking pretty good. People are saying he's the next GSP, with a quick TKO victory over Mike Pyle. Matt Hamill retires from mixed martial arts now. You know, good luck, man. Alexander Gustafsson, he has still never been to a unanimous decision in his UFC career. That guy is looking pretty serious. He's showing a lot. Chad Mendes continues his winning streak in the featherweight division, and yet Kenny Florian still gets the title shot against Jose Aldo before him by defeating Rani Yaya. Johnny Hendricks got the win, so did Mike Brown, finally. And Jorge Rivera lost to Konstantinos Filipou. Brian Ebersole looking really good, defeating Dennis Hallman. And Vitor Belfort back on the winning track. Belfort saying that he wants a top middleweight next. He wants to fight for the title again, all that stuff. With Yoshihiro Akiyama, this is a tough spot. He could get cut. But Joe Silva says they like guys that war. So that's how it goes. And Rashad Evans becomes the first man since Chuck Liddell back at UFC like 66 to finish off Tito Ortiz. Evans did look good. I'm glad he went out there with conviction and with the confidence to not just go in there and wrestle Tito Ortiz to win a unanimous decision, but he went there, he brought the excitement, and he finished him off with punches and strikes. As for Tito Ortiz now, this isn't, you know, he's still kind of a winner coming out of this fight. Because he has the submission victory over Ryan Bader, or he finally got a win. This is not terrible. Tito Ortiz is going to fight maybe a couple more times in the UFC, but he's also the first fighter to have 25 fights in the UFC. That's the record. And Evans next will face his protege, Johnny Bones Jones. I don't think that what Rashad Evans showed against Tito Ortiz will beat John Jones, but that's another review entirely. Now let's jump ahead briefly to... Okay, I got 3 minutes down. Dan Hardy versus Chris Lytle. I picked Chris Lytle to win, and he did it. I didn't think he was going to submit Dan Hardy, but that's how it goes. Great job, Chris Lytle. You really left your mark in MMA, for lack of a better term. And as for Dan Hardy, this is a really tough situation. He shouldn't have attempted that takedown in a fight in which he was losing anyway, but with now 4 losses in a row, Dan Hardy is still not cut yet, because he's popular, and the UFC likes to keep guys that bring the action like that. I personally have never been really that impressed with Dan Hardy, so that's what happens. And Ben Henderson really gave an impressive performance that night in defeating Jim Miller. I picked Jim Miller to win, but he wasn't able to get it done. This is tough for Jim Miller right now also, because he was on a 7-fight winning streak, so he's really going to have to put together another good couple of wins before he's even considered for a title shot again. And with Ben Henderson, maybe have him fight Clay Guida, or Melvin Gallard, but I think they're going to give him the winner of Edgar versus Maynard 3. So, yep. Also, I wanted to put it out there that I think Charles Oliveira should drop down in weight. And I think he's going to after losing to Don Cerrone. Oliveira's a talented fighter, but sometimes he just wilts under guys that are, you know, can strike hard or more at an upper level than he is. So Oliveira can tap out guys like Nick Lentz, but he needs to step it up a bit more. So I'm going to continue, stop right there. And then next video, let's talk about Silva versus Okami. Peace out.